Hi, my name is Marcin Wawrzyniak and I'm from the Department of Gastroenterology and Hepatology at the University Hospital in Zurich in Switzerland. I would like to present today our paper published in Allergy, which describes genetic signature that differentiates inflamed and non-inflamed fibrotic tissues in eosinophilic esophagitis patients. Esophageal biopsies and clinical data were collected from patients enrolled in the Swiss eosinophilic esophagitis cohort study. We collected biopsies and performed mRNA next-generation sequencing, and we analyzed esophageal biopsies from five different groups. Non-EU controls, also from non-fibrotic but either inflamed or not inflamed EoE patients, and also from fibrotic but either inflamed or not inflamed EoE patients. In the first step, we performed principal component analysis. Here, each dot corresponds to the patient sample. Principal component analysis demonstrates that patients with inflamed EoE cluster together regardless of the presence or absence of fibrosis and are separated from non-inflamed EoE and healthy controls. It is well described that fibrosis is a result of the chronic inflammation. To identify genes that are characteristic for fibrotic tissues, we perform two types of analysis. In the first analysis, we compared each of EoE groups versus control groups. And by this analysis, we found a list of genes which were characteristic for inflamed fibrotic and also a list of genes characterized for non-inflamed fibrotic tissues. For the specific names and whole list of the genes, you could refer to our paper. In the second analysis, we thought that we will analyze the data in the way that fibrosis status is constant and the inflammation status is a variable. That's why we compared inflamed fibrotic groups versus non-inflamed fibrotic groups. And also we compare inflamed non-fibrotic versus non-inflamed non-fibrotic groups. And similarly, in this analysis, we found genes which were up and down regulated but characteristic for inflamed fibrotic. For the detailed name of the genes, please refer to our paper. Then we ask how we could identify genes specific for inflamed fibrotic tissues. We thought the best way would be to find the genes which were shared between analysis number one and analysis number two. And in this way, we found 18 genes which were upregulated, 19 genes which were downregulated, characteristic for fibrotic tissues, which means they were coming from the analysis where we compared inflamed fibrotic tissues versus healthy controls, analysis number one, and the non-inflamed fibrotic tissues, analyzed number two. Here you could see the heat maps for genes upregulated and downregulated in inflamed fibrotic tissues. And upregulated genes were known here to drive cell proliferation. They are involved in fibroblast activation and they enhance extracellular matrix production. This in turn might support fibrosis progression. Among the genes which were downregulated, like DCORIN or GREM1, they are known to weaken antifibrotic control, which might in turn allow uncontrolled fibroblast activity. The open question which remains here is, can the proposed list of genes represent possible therapeutic targets when specifically targeting fibrosis in EoE? This we don't know, we are working on it, and hopefully with the next paper, we can answer this question. With that, I would like to thank everyone who was involved in the study, especially patients and members of Swiss EoE cohort study group, and you for your attention. Thank you very much.